In this video, we're going to introduce you to one of our favourite apps for learning any topic, Anki. At Darrigov Research, we specialise in open source software, hardware and education to help tackle global issues in your local community. Unfortunately, we live in a world where access to information and scalable educational resources is not evenly distributed. But we believe that Anki can be a strong part of the solution to help tackle this issue. So, in today's video, we'll be covering what Anki is and how to get started. This includes how to download the Anki app, where you can find and download existing flashcards, importing flashcards onto the app, how to revise using Anki, how to edit the flashcards, and how to create your own. And we're also going to include some features of Anki that we think are really cool. Introduction to Anki. Anki is a piece of open source software available on all platforms to learn and revise things in a flashcard format. Now, it's based on a concept known as spaced repetition that allows you to push knowledge from short-term memory into long-term memory. One of the models of the way that memory works is that when you learn something, it takes a small amount of time to forget the content you've learned. If you relearn the given content, it takes much longer to forget, and even longer if you relearn after that. The way the Anki algorithm works is that you learn it today, it tests you tomorrow. If you know it tomorrow, it will test you in 2 days' time. In 2 days' time, if you know it, it will test you in 3 days' time, and so on. That way, it specifically retests you when you start to forget, so that it extends your long-term memory retention. If you don't know it, it resets your progress back to the beginning. Anki can use various forms of media to help you learn, including images, audio, HTML, Markdown, LaTeX, and more, so it can be used for the majority of topics that you would like to learn. Anki has been very popular in industries that require a lot of immediate recall of very large amounts of information. For example, linguists and medics. Now, if you go to an A&E and you have, for example, a broken spine, you're not going to expect the doctor to, flip through multiple textbooks in order to find the name of that specific bone. No. The doctor needs to be able to know large amounts of information and have it available immediately in order to provide you with great care that is efficient and effective. If you're trying to find some content to learn, there is an online directory of flashcards called Shared Decks that people have made available to everyone. Be warned that the quality of these shared decks can sometimes be hit and miss. We have more than 40 sets of flashcards based on open source work, which includes topics such as machine learning, robotics, electronics, mathematics, history, foreign languages, and more. So feel free to take a look if there are any topics there that may be of interest to you. Anki flashcards are built up of decks which contain cards. The collection is what contains all of the decks in your workspace. On desktop, you can have multiple user profiles, but this is not enabled on mobile. Another thing we like about Anki is that it's very easy to pick up and put down, so you don't have to feel the need to revise everything in one big sitting every day. How to download the app? Go to the website apps.ankiweb.net. Click download and it will take you to the download section of the page. Select what platform you are using for desktop and follow the instructions. The same goes for Android and iOS, but you go via their app store. How to find pre-existing flashcards? You can find pre-existing flashcards from our website or from the Shared Decks website. To find flashcards from our website, go to darigovresearch.com. You will find a section on educational material and specifically a subsection on flashcards. Pick out a topic that is of interest to you and it will open the dedicated page on the website for that set of flashcards. Feel free to read the page as it gives you context to where that specific set of flashcards came from and specific notes on how it has been updated. The download button is usually in the section Getting Started. Click on that and it will save it to your downloads folder. To find flashcards from Anki's shared decks, you can access more decks that other people have made very easily, as both the desktop and Android app can open the exact page required. On desktop, click Get Shared at the bottom of the page and it will open the website. On Android, click the plus button on the bottom right-hand corner of the page. Then click Get Shared Decks and it will open the specific website from within the app. Now you can search for whatever topic you're interested in. You can see that there are some example categories from the start page. Just note that the search is very literal, so it won't give you similar results, or if you spell it incorrectly, it may seem that there aren't any flashcards on the topic. It will then give you a list of flashcards with the relative ratings and number of notes in the deck. Click on the title to access the given page. You will now see more details like a description, download size, how many images or bits of audio there are, and some samples of what is contained in the deck. You can also see some reviews at the bottom of the page. Click the download button and it should have been downloaded to your downloads folder on your device. How to import existing flashcards in Anki. On desktop, click File, Import or the Import File button at the bottom of the homepage. Select the APKG file which you had downloaded earlier. Click Open. You should then receive a confirmation window saying how many cards have been imported and even a text preview of the cards that were added as a sanity check. On mobile, on the homepage, click on the three dots on the top right-hand corner. Select the file from your file browser. It will then ask you to confirm the one you want, as it can sometimes take a long time to import all of the cards. Then click Add. It will then show you the progress at each of the steps. It will then have a confirmation window with the number of cards that it has read, as a quick sanity check for you. Click OK and you will find the new deck is now in your collection. How to revise in Anki. When you have a deck downloaded into Anki, you will see a line with the name of the deck of flashcards. At the start, you will only see the number 20 to the right of the deck. There are three numbers you will usually see, each of which are in different colours. Blue, red/orange, and green, which corresponds to new, learning, and to review. New signifies cards which you have never seen before. Learning signifies cards which you have seen before but haven't learnt. And to review signifies cards which you have seen before and it is prompting you to revise them. This is because, by default, Anki prevents you from overlearning by setting some defaults. This includes number of new cards viewable daily, 20 by default, and the total number of cards to view per day. This is to prevent burnout and so you don't spend all your day learning a specific topic. Click on the deck to view the preview page on desktop. Or click on the numbers on the right-hand side of Android for the equivalent on mobile. This will tell you some overview numbers of the deck itself to provide you more context. Then click Study or Study Now, depending on if you're on Android or desktop, and it will put you into the revision screen of the application. Depending on the context, you will usually see the front side of the flashcard, and you'll see a button saying Show Answer. This is when you would guess what you think the back side of the flashcard says, and click on it to see if you are correct. When you do so, you will now see the three buttons appear on the bottom of the page, and by default, these are Again, Good, and Easy. These signify how confident you believe your knowledge retention of that particular card is. I need to see it again. I have a good level of confidence, or that was easy. As you can see, these buttons have small numbers on them, and by default, Again has less than 1 m, which means test me again in less than 1 minute. Good has less than 10 m, which means test me again in less than 10 minutes. And Easy has 4D, which means test me again in 4 days. The second and third button will increase in number if you are being retested after having seen the card for the first time. Click on the one you deem most appropriate and it will retest you in that time frame. Continue with all the cards in the lineup for the day, and if you get them all right, Anki will put you back into the homepage of the app. If you don't finish all the cards set for you today, the new card number will reset the next day, but any retest will be added to your two review cards. Hence, sometimes why you see people complaining that they have a lot to revise when they haven't been using Anki for a few days. How to create a deck by yourself. First, you need to create the blank deck to start with. On desktop, click Create Deck on the home screen and fill in the name. Or, on Android, click the plus button in the bottom right-hand corner and then click Create Deck and fill in the name. To add cards to the deck, on desktop, click Add in the top of your screen, fill in the front and back of the card. Feel free to use the additional features available. Ensure you have the correct deck selected. Then click Add. Or, on Android, click the plus button in the bottom right-hand corner, then add. Fill in the same details as for desktop, and then click the check button in the top right-hand corner to add it to the deck. You should now see it added to the deck if you have set everything up correctly. Do play around with the additional things that you can add to the card, such as images, sound files, and more. And really use it to your advantage to learn the content that you're passionate about. Then repeat for all the remaining content that you wish to revise.
How to view the card browser. The card browser is a way to see, edit, and improve the flashcards that you already have in your collection.
On desktop, click the Browse menu, which will open a new window. You can select various sets of cards on the left-hand side, either by deck or by card type. In order to edit a card, you need to click it from the rows in the center of the screen, and the fields update automatically if you edit them in the bottom of the screen. This is where you can also add tags. On Android, click on the menu button in the top right-hand part of the screen, then Card Browser. You can select the deck from the top filter and can search as well. Click on the row item to open the fields of that particular card which you can edit, and it will update automatically.
Notes on bulk importing.
If you're adding a lot of cards to a deck, you don't need to do so individually, but you can bulk import from a text file. This is what we do for our sets of flashcards, which can be found on our website.
How to import from a text file.
Same as before, you select the file, but you may need to select what delimiter is being used to separate the different fields. We tend to use a character that is not found in the content that we revise, like this OR symbol. Sometimes it is used as an OR symbol in mathematics topics, so we use the negation symbol, which is less common than commas, colons, or semicolons in most pieces of text. Note that it takes the estimated number of fields from the first parsed field, so make sure it is representative of the rest of the source file. Otherwise, the rest of the cards may not import correctly. When importing via a text file or the like, you need to be careful on any errors on importing, as they will only be visible on the first import. The way around this is to remove the cards. Go to the card browser, select the deck you're importing into, click on one of the rows. Press Ctrl plus A to select all of the rows, then Ctrl plus Delete to delete them from the deck. Then try to re-import the cards from the source file as you've done before after making the relevant adjustments. You usually only import via a text file from the desktop application, as it is more appropriate for building flashcards where mobile is good for revising on the go. A quick note on multiple fields. You don't need to have two fields when making flashcards. This means you can have dedicated fields for whatever you're learning, for example, an image, text, and pronunciation. And Anki can auto-generate which fields display first, so if you want to practice listening, reading, or pronunciation, you can.
Note on why having flashcards on your mobile is useful. Now, very often, having flashcards on your mobile is much more useful than having on the desktop, simply because you can be anywhere in the world and still revise using your smartphone. I mean, you can even squeeze in some revision whilst waiting for the bus. And we're based in London, and we know that the tubes can get so packed sometimes during a commute that you don't even have the space to open up a book. But you can still revise using your phone. How to view statistics.
Anki comes out of the box with a great statistics system, so you can really get some insight into your learning patterns and see what your progress has been so far. This gives some accountability for when you haven't been learning or revising. On desktop, click on the Stats submenu and you can filter on various parameters, like if you wish to see stats for the deck or the whole collection and from what time frame. You can even save it down as a PDF. On AnkiDroid, the Android version of Anki, you need to click on the menu icon in the top left-hand corner and then click on Statistics. The statistics are split up into different tabs instead of on one page, and you can filter by the same parameters from the top of your screen. Note that you actually have to have used Anki for any statistics to be visible. So if this is the first time you've been using Anki, the data may not be so enlightening.
Addons in Anki. For desktop apps, you can download extensions to improve the functionality on top of the already great functionality. Now, we'll be doing deep dives on specific extensions later, but this is how you do it.
Go to Tools, Add-ons, and it will open the add-on window. Click Get Add-ons, then Browse Add-ons, and it will open up your web browser to the right page. It will show a list of all add-ons in the Anki web with ratings, date modified, and Anki version.
This is because some add-ons were built for a previous version of Anki and may not be compatible with your installation. As with shared decks, it has voting buttons, description, comments, along with an add-on number. Find an add-on you like and retrieve the add-on code and copy it to your clipboard. Go back to the Anki desktop, paste it into the field and click OK. Restart Anki and the features should now be enabled. Each add-on will have different functionalities, so seeing that it is installed correctly, you will need to know the core functionality of the add-on. You can usually find this in the description on the website. Some good examples of add-ons we like are Awesome TTS, Close, and Multi Preview. We have some ideas for some add-ons we would like to build, and we hope to show you the process on building them in the future.
One of the most common questions that we get is, why is the iOS version of the app paid when all the other versions are free? This is because the desktop versions of Anki are all open source and therefore free to access. Now, the main way that the original creator, Damien Elms, is remunerated for their great work is via the iOS app. And personally, we believe that the cost of the app on mobile is well worth the price when you think about the accessibility that you get to be able to revise anywhere in the world. Also, you can consider it roughly the price of a book that you'd probably be happy to pay for if it's a topic that you're interested in enough that you're happy to make flashcards for it. However, we would recommend that you try the free versions first just to get used to it. And or if you just want to simply contribute to the amazing creator of this amazing software, then feel free to go and get it straight from the iOS App Store. It's also a good gift idea as it can open up ease of use for someone who wants to learn any new topic. Speaking of supporting great people doing work in open source, you can like this video, if you did, subscribe to our channel, and turn on your post notifications if you wish to be notified of any new uploads. You can also follow us on our social media accounts, and if you wish to support us monetarily, you can do that directly via our website, diaryofresearch.com/donate. Or via Patreon. Patreon is a platform available to people to support the content creators that they care about in a sustainable way. There are various different tiers that you can sign up for and get perks, such as Patreon-only posts, early access to content, and more. So, this was a quick whirlwind tour of Anki, why it's important, how to find existing flashcards, how to revise, and how to make your own. We hope you found it useful, and we hope we've inspired you to hopefully build some of your own flashcards that you've kind of on a topic that you've wanted to learn for a while, but maybe you've just been putting it off. And please, if you do so, please share it with us on social media because we'd love to see your progress. And we'd just like to say thank you so much for watching this video, and we hope to see you in the next one.